Look, only the Mets. Only the Mets. You know how that video got out? They posted it to their team website. Because, you know, the Mets. Cue up the clown music. Brodie Van Wagenen caught on a hot mic calling out Rob Manfred. Couple of things, starting with this. Brodie's right. Rob Manfred absolutely, positively does not get it. And let me take you a step further. As the Mets tried to clean it up and Brodie had to give a press conference apologizing and the Wilpons threw him under the bus, threw their general manager under the bus, I actually believe Brodie Van Wagenen. That was a private moment. I believe that Rob Manfred genuinely, 100%, told the Mets, hey, we need to get this game in. Because he doesn't get it on a leadership level, and that's part of the deal. So the Mets, with the Brodie apology, they forced him into saying that. The apology, oh. And they said it was Jeff Wilpon who came up with that idea. Because they could pin it on Jeff Wilpon, and that's the most asinine idea ever, you know, because that's not what a protest is about. You know, we're not going to play at 7:10, but hey, at 8:10, we're going to have first pitch an hour later. That's a great protest. That makes a statement. Are you only the Mets? Look, and obviously it's been documented on our show for forever. I mean, I think the Wilpons are the absolute worst. They're a buffoonish ownership group, and Mets fans deserve better, and they will get it when the Wilpons sell the team. How about the Wilpons releasing statements, and they took turns backing over the truck where they were running over their general manager and misspelled his name? You can't make this up if you try. I think it was very easy for Fred Wilpon, who, you know, is still thankful that Bud Selig let him keep the team after the Madoff disaster. And, you know, Rob Manfred and Bud Selig are incredibly close. So the Wilpons are selling the team. And Jeff said, hey, I'll take the blame for this. I totally think this was completely Rob Manfred's fault because at the end of the day, here's the deal. He doesn't get it. He never will get it. And, you know, the Wilpons can't do anything right. And it's been a clown show with their leadership and owning this team. And Mets fans can't wait for them to sell the squad. But they misspelled their own general manager's name. That happens to one franchise and one franchise only, your New York Mets. You can't make this up if you tried. I think Manfred is a terrible commissioner, a terrible leader. We could talk about billionaires fighting millionaires and tone-deaf comments from Rob Manfred during the pandemic in terms of the restart and negotiations with the Players Association. You know, Manfred with the over-the-top press release yesterday. Please, we could go back to, you know, the Astros and the penalties there and how he handled it and, you know, calling the World Series trophy a piece of metal, not understanding anything about baseball, or changing the number of playoff teams right before the first pitch of the season, or changing the rules for doubleheaders in the season. I mean, Rob Manfred has no idea what he's doing. And let's be honest, he botched everything with regards to the last few days. Jack Flaherty, spot on. And only baseball couldn't unify. Only baseball. I mean, think about it. The Milwaukee Brewers rightly got it started on Wednesday, appropriately, as they took their cues from the Milwaukee Bucks. And it was real, and it was honest, and it was purposeful, and it was great. And then I want to quote some of my words back to you from the shows this week, when we talked about how Clayton Kershaw said that he wasn't going to let Mookie Betts be the only one who would sit out, and he needs to be there for his African-American brothers and teammates and the African-American community. So the Dodgers didn't play. And the Mariners didn't play because they have the most African-Americans of any baseball team. And these are facts. And Dom Smith played and took a knee and then sobbed in emotional fashion, trying to express what it's like to be an African-American in America in 2020. And you had Jason Hayward of the Chicago Cubs who told his teammates, you need to play, but he didn't play. And Flaherty refused to put on the uniform. And Dexter Fowler, African-American player for the Cardinals, he didn't play. And baseball was all over the map. They had some games yesterday. They didn't have games. And that's on Rob Manfred. And that's exactly the problem. There is no leadership. The players absolutely got it right, which is not a surprise. Rob Manfred, once again, got it wrong.